Sir, zarur baithna
chaliye.
Because we want you to be your expansive self and to put things as you always do with forthrightness. It's our pleasure to have Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, I think the most influential, erudite, and articulate voice from government today at this summit. I know we've all been looking forward to this moment because Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad has a very scholarly and studied view on some of the issues, not only because he handles some of the most sensitive portfolios for the government, but also because he's an intellectual in his own right, an opinion maker in his own right. So let me begin without any delay. Mr. Prasad, is democracy really under threat in this country? I mean, you're speaking also a day after the Delhi elections.
Thank you for the kind words. If democracy would have been under threat, I don't think we'd have lost so badly, isn't it? What do you mean? You know, at times I'm surprised. The people of India elect their leaders. They trust Prime Minister Narendra Modi for government of India. Occasionally they elect other parties for state governments. We have won so many states. We have lost Jharkhand. We have lost Delhi. All this is part of the vibrancy of Indian democracy. Lekin Rahul hame ye bataiye ki ye shikayat hai kisko ki is mulk mein jamhooriyat nahi hai. Zara unke bare mein bhi humko janne ki ichha hoti hai. Who are these people who are apprehensive about democracy? Are these eminent people are those who physically prevented the governor from speaking in Kerala because he held a different point of view? Are these people who are so intolerant that their award vapsi program is also selective? And since you have raised the issue of democracy, let me say it very clearly at the outset that India is home to many ideas, many ideologies. Okay? India is home to those who criticize the Prime Minister, to my party, to my ideology, to me or anyone else, to Home Minister. But those of my friends who are so excited about occasional and selective award vapsi program, why they maintain a conspicuous silence when Hindu young girls are raped in Pakistan, forced to convert Punjabis and Christian? Does their plight not provoke them for some initiative? That's the question which need to be asked. And why I'm a little troubled in raising this question, normally I don't do, that this whole democracy is in danger is also a voice emanating from many of these elements.
Sir, you are not defining these elements in any words. The Prime Minister has already come up with a name for them, the Khan Market Consensus, he called it. I can understand your reticence, but let me ask you, sir, because many people say the actual tukde-tukde gang today is in government. They are the ones who are posing a threat to democracy. In our election campaign in Delhi, for instance, in, you know, just a few kilometers from the Prime Minister's residence, slogans like Bharat ke gaddaron ko goli maro, people like Parvesh Verma, who are MPs, who warned against Shaheen Bagh protesters, saying that they will enter people's homes, rape women and daughters, etc., etc. You know what I'm talking about. They are the ones these people say are posing threat to democracy.
Let me tell you one thing very clearly. Some of these comments, let's not take name, I don't appreciate. And some of them were also in many ways penalized by the Election Commission. Okay? And the party at the structured level has never appreciated or justified those comments. But I need to give you a counter narrative too. What is this meaning of azadi, azadi? Kisi azadi bhai? जिसने कहा डेमोक्रेसी है तो ये मुल्क तो आज़ाद है ना, मैं अपनी बात बोल रहा हूँ, आप मुझसे सवाल पूछ रहे हैं, आपके चैनल के माध्यम से देश देख रहा है, आप मोदी जी को हरा दीजिए, कभी जिताते हैं, आपकी आज़ादी इस कदर तक है कि आप अपनी यूनिवर्सिटी को भी घेर लेते हैं, पुलिस से भी भिड़ जाते हैं, तो किससे आज़ादी? दिस क्वेश्चन हैज टू बी डिबेटेड. इलेक्शन हैज एंडेड, पीपल हैव बीन इलेक्टेड, पार्टी लीडर्स हैव बीन इलेक्टेड, दैट चैप्टर इज क्लोज. माई गुड लक टू मिस्टर केजरीवाल, लेट हिम वर्क एज पर हिज प्रोमिसेस. दैट्स वॉट द ब्यूटी ऑफ इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी इज. बट सिंस यू टॉक्ड ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, राहुल शिवशंकर, हाउ डज डेमोक्रेसी वर्क? पीपल वोट, वी हैव एन आइडिया एन एजेंडा, वी कम विद लेजिस्लेशन इन द पार्लियामेंट, दैट लेजिस्लेशन इज डिबेटेड, दैट डिबेट इज शोड ऑन योर चैनल, वोटिंग इज डन, द बिल इज पास्ड. यू हैव ए प्रॉब्लम इन दिस बिल, यू एजिटेट, यू मेक ए प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस, यू डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट, यू ऑल्सो गो टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज इश्यूड द नोटिस. These are the norms of democratic behavior. लेकिन ये कहना कि वापस नहीं लोगे तो उठेंगे नहीं, ये क्या है?
आप शाहीन बाग वालों की बात
क्यों नाम ले रहे हैं? आप उनको तवज्जो दीजिए, मैं नहीं दे रहा हूं. I am on a very disturbing culture emanating in this country. People who do not have popular approval. भैया इलेक्शन लड़ो, हमें हरा दो ना, हम कहां मना कर रहे हैं?
So you're saying
एक शाहीन, एक ऑल इंडिया शाहीन बाग पार्टी बना लो, मोदी जी को हरा दो, हम आपको नमस्ते कर देंगे. बट दिस काइंड ऑफ ए प्रोटेस्ट, आई ऑफर देम ए प्रपोजल टू टॉक, यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट.
यस,
आई ओपनली सेड द गवर्नमेंट इज विलिंग टू हैव ए स्ट्रक्चर्ड डिबेट, कम वी विल एड्रेस योर कंसर्न्स. नथिंग हैपेंड देयर आफ्टर. देयरफॉर those who are raising issues of democracy in danger, what is their conduct also needs to be debated.
But sir, that doesn't mean that we say that goli maro, and I don't want to fill in the blanks there. What you're suggesting is that the onus is on the people to punish, but not the BJP to punish their own.
What makes you say that?
Okay,
no, we don't believe, we don't do like that. We, you know, in our own way we take corrective measures, including tough measures. Leave it for us to decide.
So you're saying that tough measures will be taken against Anurag Thakur, Parvesh,
that is your inference.
But that you're saying...
That is what I'm simply saying is, the BJP as a party has never approved or appreciated. But let me ask a counter-narrative to you.
Ji.
And this is a very pida ki baat hai. Aapke chal pal ki charcha hui hai. Aapne kaha toh... छोटे छोटे बच्चों के हाथ में बंदूक रूपी खिलौना रूपी बंदूक देखा गया, मोदी को गोली मारो, क्या किसी ने उसका विरोध किया? माफ करिए, आप किसी ने विरोध किया उसका? द इनोसेंट चाइल्ड इज सॉट टू बी अब्यूज्ड. जस्ट अ मिनट. द इनोसेंस ऑफ चिल्ड्रन इज बीइंग अब्यूज्ड एट दैट पर्टिकुलर congregation or whatever you call it, a new law in the democratic polity of India. Therefore, you have to see it in totality. Now, one thing more I have to tell you, since you have raised this issue of democracy. Rahul, I see a new trend. What is that? Hindi mein bolo isko.
Ji, absolutely.
Aapki izadat hai.
Of course.
Election mein hare hue hatash log, आजकल कोल्यूसिव PIL खूब फाइल कर देते हैं.
कोल्यूसिव PIL,
ऑब्वियसली आई से एवरी वर्ड विद ग्रेट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. वॉट इज दैट कोल्यूसिव PIL? इफ एनी मिनिस्टर इज कमिटिंग करप्शन, हैंग हिम. इफ एनी वर्कर्स आर बीइंग डिनाइड देयर ह्यूमन राइट्स, इंटरवीन. बट दीज PILs हैव एन एजेंडा, एंड वॉट इज एजेंडा? देश हम चलाएंगे सुप्रीम कोर्ट के कॉरिडोर से. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड, नाउ आई हैव क्लैरिफाइड इट. तो लेट मी टेल दीज ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू हैव द गट्स, इफ यू हैव द करेज, प्लंज इनटू द इलेक्शन अगेंस्ट, डिफीट अस, रूल द कंट्री. but those who have been defeated, those who have been rejected repeatedly, will not run the country by filing collusive PIL in the corridors of Supreme Court.
So on the people who have lost, let's talk a little bit about the Congress and their criticism. Rahul Gandhi
you are trying to be specific. I am going to be general. We are talking about democracy of the country.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm only going to state the quote, and I
don't want to give them more respect and prestige by taking their names here.
Okay, so I won't quote them, but I will quote what they said. This individual said, a free and fair election requires the neutrality of a country's institutions. An election cannot be fair without arbiters, a free press, an independent judiciary, a transparent election commission, and is objective and neutral. Nor can election be free if one party has complete monopoly on financial resources. He goes on to say that the BJP has, however, undermined all institutions and weakened Indian democracy. How do you respond to that?
Why are you bringing Rahul Gandhi? Because of late, I am trying to avoid him. Okay. Because unko ye mulk kitna samajh mein aata hai, is par charcha karni padegi. Today, Rahul, but since they have raised all those allegations by him against us, one thing is very curious. The Congress party has lost his deposit nearly all the constituencies in Delhi. Fortunately, he has not blamed the EVM. And that's very interesting. Maybe because we did not win. Who castigated publicly the election commission? Who publicly derided the CAG? Who gave oblique comments against the Supreme Court? Who is making these kinds of allegations against the media? Because Rahul Gandhi cannot face you directly, na? Who? You just had the chief of defense staff before me, I saw.
Yes.
Who compromised the integrity of Indian armed forces as an institution? Who was seeking evidence ki Balakot mein tumne kiya ya nahi kiya, batao? These are very troubling moments in the polity of India. Who compromised the need for new aircraft for the Indian Air Force? You know, it was so troubling. And by the way, who clouded the respect of the institution, the Prime Minister of India? I don't want to name the very shameful slogan which he kept on repeating all over the country and rejected by the people of India with impunity. These are issues which need to be raised.
Article 370. Your government abrogated parts of the article. Many people say did not have the consent of the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly. And therefore, the people of Jammu and Kashmir, by extension. How are you upholding democracy when you took a decision like that, that is supposed to have not been consultative?
I think all the representatives of Jammu and Kashmir, from Jammu region to Ladakh region to the valley, members of parliament spoke when the debate was going on, okay? And because of the president rule, the Lok Sabha exercises the power of the Vidhan Sabha, constitutionally speaking. That debate is passed. But taking benefit of your presence, this program, let me share with ladies and gentlemen present here. Recently, I had gone to Sopor and Baramulla. The PM has directed all the ministers to be there, about 30. And the senior ministers were asked to go in the valley. In -5 degrees, I had gone for the first time. The cold was bitter, but the warmth was really very energizing. And I would like to use the opportunity of Times Now Conclave to let the nation know what they feel about it. You know, this whole Block Development Council and Sarpanch Panchas have been elected. I met about 1,000 people in both the places. Hundreds of delegations I met, nearly 50 individual meetings. It was 23rd of January. A newly elected BDC, Block Development Chairman, came to me, sir, this is my gift to you. It was Azad Hind Cap because January 23 was the birthday of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. This was where? In Baramulla. In Sopore, they raised only one question to me, and that is very important. Baramulla has 300 varieties of apple. And during harvest season, Rahul, from the apple mandi of Sopore, 450 trucks go every day loaded with apple in different parts of India and also Bangladesh. What they demanded, sir, hamari mandi ko e-mandi bana dijiye. And there is overpowering anger against the leaders who misled them, and also the way no accountability was there. I don't want to name it. I seek Jammu and Kashmir for a new narrative. As a Minister of Communication, I opened the first all-women post office in Srinagar. And I had called all the women employees of Srinagar in postal department to be there. I could see a refreshing change happening. So let it allow to happen. They want new opportunity. And one thing I would like to say, what I could gather, and I also wrote an article about this in a newspaper. Hame sachchai nahi batai gai. Jab Bajpayee ne darwaza khola, to humne dekha POK mein Hindustan, Kashmiri kitne jillat ki zindagi jeete hain. Bade logon ne ek hamare samne ek gubara dikhaya 370 ka. To hum kahin ke nahi rahe. And good governance and accountability became a big casualty. And thirdly, the most important, Rahul, Dashat Gardi ultimately was killing also the Muslims of the valley. And what is the positive upshot you need to know? Engaging them with good governance and tough against terrorists. Aap apne channel mein 15 agar 26 January ko Pakistani jhande ko khub dikhate the na? Valley mein? Ab kisi ki himmat hai kya? Nahi hai. Koi Pakistani jhande nahi lagayega. So, yes, sakti bhi humne kiya.
But you went as a minister. Many people are saying that these are all, this is a guided democratic tour. Agar itni himmat hai, so why don't you allow opposition leaders to go there unaccompanied? Why don't we release the people who are pro-India in the valley? Why is PSA slapped on them? Why is it a threat for Mehbooba Mufti to be her, father's daughter? Arbitrariness, detentions, you have suffered under the emergency, is being explained, sir, as a national security imperative. How can this be, sir?
देखिए कुछ तो लोग कहेंगे लोगों का काम है कहना
मगर उमर अब्दुल्ला
वो तो कहेंगे ना
देखिए
बल आप एक बात समझिए lot of people have been released. There is no curfew anywhere. Substantial internet has been restored. Mobile SMS have been restored. Nearly 800 white websites have been opened.
But Sitaram Yechuri can't go there.
No, just a minute. Sitaram Yechuri should not be allowed to go there. Because the problem is, ki if you are determined to create some kind of a hangama there. Rahul, you must understand, the tragedy of Kashmir is 70 years old. More than 60,000 people have been killed. More than 5,000 forces have been killed, Hindu and Muslim both. Kashmir mein kya khoya ya paya, kabhi to baat karni padegi na. Ab tak 10 lakh crore se upar humne diya. And I have been visiting Kashmir for too long. Earlier, I was a secretary of the committee to assess the situation in Kashmir. And let me use the platform of Times now for a very sensitive thing. Jo Pakistan se aaye the, batware ke baad, woh nagrik nahi the. Badi zillat ki zindagi jeete the. Hum unse milne gaye the. Unne kaha hamari ek hi galti thi ki Sheikh Abdullah aur Nehru ji ko bharosa karke hum yahan reh gaye. और जो हमारे साथ पंजाब और आगे चले गए वो हिंदुस्तान के प्राइम मिनिस्टर और डिप्टी प्राइम मिनिस्टर बन गए हम नागरिक भी नहीं हैं ये था कश्मीर आज उनको हमने इज्जत की जिंदगी दी है आम कश्मीरियों को इज्जत की जिंदगी दी है तो कश्मीर के जिन लोगों ने आर्टिकल 370 के नैरेटिव पर अपनी पूरी सियासत बनाई. यू नो व्हाट वाज कश्मीर. आई आल्सो रोट दैट एंड लेट मी रिपीट. मरकज से पैसे ले लेंगे. मरकज मींस गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. लेकिन उस पैसे का हिसाब नहीं देंगे. दैट वॉज द अगर हिसाब मांगोगे तो हम आजाद है आर्टिकल 370. दैट वॉज द नॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नेंस ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वे द कॉमन पीपल द गद्दीज द पहाड़ीज द गुज्जर्स द बकरवाल्स हैड नो वॉइस एट ऑल. द पहाड़ीज टूडे दे आर कमिंग टू द मेन स्ट्रीम एंड टू थ्री फैमिलीज हु सॉट टू मोनोपोलाइज द इंटायर नैरेटिव ऑफ कश्मीर विल हैव टू नाउ adjust in their own way, let the people decide.
But Mr. Prasad, this adjustment is obviously an invocation to circumscribing their basic democratic rights. The people are saying, international press is saying, I'm sure as the law minister of the country, communications, IT minister, you know the criticism that has been coming in Washington Post, New York Times, across the globe, New Yorker. People are saying that the Indian The Indian government
आपको इंटरप्ट करूं
majoritarian
आपको इंटरप्ट करूं गुस्ताखी माफ. न्यूयॉर्क टाइम्स ने 5.5 साल में 2 लाइन भी नरेंद्र मोदी की सरकार में अच्छा लिखा है क्या मुझे बता दीजिए. आई एम ए ग्रेट सपोर्टर ऑफ फ्रीडम ऑफ प्रेस बट एट टाइम्स द एब्यूजिव मैनर इन विच देयर जर्नलिस्ट राइट अबाउट इंडिया.
Abusive, not. I'm saying questioning, speaking truth to
Sorry,
power. Nothing
questioning
wrong with
that. Is one thing. Abuse is different.
So you believe that this comes under the category of sustained abuse?
No, no, not this. I only say they have got the right to ask questions.
Yes.
Don't misunderstand me. But I thought this concern of ours also need to be flagged. Okay? What is important is that elections will be held there. Why not? Let things become normal. Let everything go in process. Let terrorism be completely under control. But Kashmir is and Kashmir will remain a part of India. If anyone tries to break Kashmir, sorry, that will not be allowed to succeed.
But that will come down. That will come down to a selective interpretation or subjective interpretation rather. What means break by what you mean by break India? Why shouldn't we allow the opposition to go there? I'll come back to that question. You said
no, we are not stopping it. Don't misunderstand me.
Okay.
Mr. Sitharaman Yechury went to the Supreme Court and the Supreme Court allowed him to go and meet his comrade. He was unwell. Bring him to Delhi. Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad also allowed to go there. But if you go there to provoke people, I don't think the time is right.
They call it dissidents. They call it dissidents. They say, no, we are just going there to tell people about their rights, which they're not getting to hear because there's a communication blackdown. I mean, in the international community, sir, you have seen the critiques that have come out in various reports about how India has fallen many places. Internet blockades are used to muzzle the real voice of the people, anti-CA protests. Whenever we want, we switch off. Kashmir, wherever you want, we switch off.
I must then explain this. I'm happy you have raised this question. क्या करें इंटरनेट को एब्यूज करा करके देश में कम्युनल कन्फ्लिग्रेशन कराएं ये हम नहीं तय करते हैं. ये तय करता है कलेक्टर. एंड इन द पार्लियामेंट आई गेव अ रिपोर्ट नॉट रिपोर्ट मेंशन द फैक्ट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स विद द बीजेपी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स और द नॉन बीजेपी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स ऑल हैव बीन यूजिंग दीज प्रोविजन फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम टू कंटेन कम्युनल वायलेंस extremism, etc. You know, my friends, I would like to just tell you, how did ISIS prosper? Powered by information technology, social media. How does all these extremists and terrorists across the border seek to foment trouble? By abusing social media. Can we deny that in many parts of India, during the Namaz day on Friday, a very dangerous kind of propagation for action used to be circulated in a particular time? How is it, and because I also handle the IT portfolio and yes. also law, so let me explain this. How is it and why is it that on a particular day, in a particular area, around a particular time on a particular issue, lakhs of messages are circulated and recirculated, leading to lynching and violence. We have been very tough. Who started it? Someone from India or someone from abroad? Therefore, when you talk of internet, now let me don my hat as the law minister. Freedom of speech is there, Rahul Babu. But 19.2 Constitution says it can be regulated for the safety, security, integrity of India. Therefore, if you start a campaign to break India by abusing our freedom of speech on the social media, surely action must follow.
Supreme Court said the power under Section 144 cannot be used to suppress legitimate expression of opinion or grievance or exercise of any democratic rights, unquote. So, Mr. Prasad, while you may claim that Kashmir has been relatively peaceful, have you really endeared yourself to the people of the valley by making them live in a lockdown? That's what the Supreme Court is now beginning to question.
Supreme Court judgment is supreme. Everyone has to abide by that. They have given an interpretation on 144. 144 cannot be permanent. But I differ with your interpretation about the situation in Kashmir, because hardly a fortnight ago, I was in Kashmir. And Sopor, ladies and gentlemen, was the hotbed of terrorism for more than 10 years. If thousands of people can come and meet me and I can discuss openly with them, if I inaugurate developmental projects in Baramulla, I want to tell you, we open an indoor stadium. It was so emotional for me to see young boys and girls doing yoga, doing...
But these were not hand-picked people.
No, not at all, They were little kids, wrestling, playing baseball, basketball. I also played with them. And when I go to Sopor, what is the demand? Hame bhi indoor stadium chahiye. Because obviously, during winters, you can't play outside because of snow. The question I need to ask is why it was not provided till now. Therefore, the real narrative of Kashmir also need to come out.
As law ministers, are you concerned that increasingly sedition charges are slapped against people who are categorized as from the Break India League? Are we today becoming less tolerant to the free expression of dissent? I'm not just talking about BJP rule states, I'm talking about opposition rule states also. Will you move towards removing sedition from the books and laws like criminal defamation?
Main bahut iska saral bhasha mein jawab de deta hu. Agar criminal defamation ko khatam karenge to ye bataiye ki log kya kya bolte hain. Something new is happening in the country. Revenge porn. You know that? Boys and girls split up and then the girl is being victimized. So kya kare? Desh ka IT minister khamosh rahe? Aap jimmewar sampadak hai, aapka channel hai. Kaun-kaun se channel jameen par blackmailing karke kya kya karte hai, news chala karke, to khamosh raha jaye? Ye aap log baat karte hai na, to lagta hai ki hawa mein aap log hain. Arre jara jameen par bhi aaiye, and how some people are abusing the platform of free expression, media needs to be understood. Then I talk about sedition. You're absolutely right. There should not be an abuse of this power. I am completely against it.
Yeah, I mean, there is a young girl in Karnataka who today is pining for her mother.
I have not examined it. I have my sympathy for her. And if there is something wrong, surely the police will look into it. If someone has been falsely implicated, charge sheet has been filed, there is a whole magisterial system in the country, judicial system, to dismiss that charge. But there's also an alternative view that the police is seeking to file a charge sheet and some gentleman is not giving the permission to file the charge sheet. You also know that. When you ask me to respond to removal of the provision of sedition, can you honestly tell me there are not people in this country out to break the country? Can you confirm that? What the urban next slide, the Maoist, their agenda is what?
The criticism is it's selectively applied sedition. Therefore, dissenters are mixed up with anti-national elements, bona fide anti-national elements.
I must tell you, if someone comes and criticizes Mr. Modi or my party or my government, he has the right to.
But there are people who call them urban naxals. There are people who call them tukre, the people who are calling. And then there's a
Rahul, you are making your assumptions very, very general, which I tend to differ, because as a minister, we have a lot of informations. Okay? India is not that simple. Let me tell you, there are forces in the country out to weaken India. Let me ask you a question, a very concrete question. A nuclear plant was coming in Tamil Nadu. Okay? Nuclear power plant. Lots of environmental issues were raised. The matter went to Supreme Court. And when the final fact came about, which were the forces propagating it for the last more than 8-9 years, was known. The same thing I see in the IT sector, I see in other sectors, there are forces. I don't grudge those forces, criticize, also remain on the payroll of outside forces. But if you'll try to break India, action will be taken and must be taken. That's how we see it.
No, all I'm saying, sir, and we're running out of time, so perhaps the last two questions.
No, but before you ask question, let me clarify my last observations here. And I would like you to think about it. Can you enter America straight away? You cannot. You have to be a citizen or you must have the visa. Can you enter England, France, Germany, Switzerland? All these countries are democracy, where people elect their government. There, if a charter and register of citizens are maintained, it is okay. But in India, if you mention it, then people have a problem. What is this? The second issue, very important. Think about it. Can you become a voter only by being a citizen of India? No. You have to have your name in the voter list. Plus, you must have your voter I card. You click the button here outside. Your name will come on the website, Election Commission, your father's name, your mother's name, your mobile number. And voter list is also changed from time to time. If you don't remain in Delhi, your name will be deleted, others will be added. So some people are very keen to become voters and their names in the voter list. Then they will tell their father's name, their mother's name, their everyone. They say we will not give any evidence. Now the Ramallah lawyer is talking to you in the Allahabad High Court. Okay? They will say, no, hum koi saboot nahi denge. Lekin Prabhu Ram Lalla ko Ayodhya mein janm liye ki nahi janm liye, apna pura saboot do. Sanskrit mein bhi, Farsi mein bhi, Persian mein bhi, aur Ram Lalla jite Supreme Court se. What is this? These narratives have to be challenged. And I'm provoking you, Mr. Rahul Shivshankar, to have this debate in the entire country. Why not? You ask me of being selective. I am telling the entire narrative is selective. And therefore, I give 2-3-6 examples. About CA, we'll talk separately. It has nothing to do with India at all. It will not touch any Indian Muslim included. But National Population Register?
Expose these people. No problems.
So, महान संपादक राहुल शिवशंकर कब मुझे इन विषयों पर ले आएंगे तो आप करें लास्ट टू क्वेश्चंस ऐसे कैसे चलेगा खाली आप ही पूछिएगा क्या हम भी आपसे पूछेंगे ध्यान रखा करिए चलिए
बट वन सेकंड आई वांट टू आस्क यू बिकॉज़ सर दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वी मस्ट
देन व्हाई द इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन कमिंग इन द लास्ट
आई आस्क यू दिस क्वेश्चन द कांस्टेंट क्रिटिसिज्म इज दैट द गवर्नमेंट labels too conveniently individuals who stand up and ask questions. There was a contestant from your own party who said that the fight in Delhi, for example, is between India versus Pakistan, suggesting that those today who may be protesting for whatever reasons, may have a problem against the government for whatever reason, are all Pakistanis. Is that healthy for a democracy?
Well, whosoever has said it, I don't appreciate it. As a senior party worker, let me tell you. But you must also understand. No, just a minute. You must also understand the context of it. If on Pakistan television, in the news channels, their leaders and the commentators and the sampadaks, Rahul Shivshankar not, are demanding that let the BJP be defeated in Delhi elections, and let some gentleman in some party be elected, तो ये विषय क्यों नहीं बनना चाहिए? देखिए राहुल,
विषय तो बने.
राहुल एक आप लोग की समस्या है, सुनिए आप समस्या क्या है.
मैं ये कह रहा हूँ,
पहले पहले मेरी बात कर,
उनको सिडिशन चार्ज के नीचे क्यों
थोड़ा थोड़ा आप भी तो सुना करिए थोड़ा सा. हाँ, व्यंग, ह्यूमर, पन, कार्टून, इन सम वे जेंटल लेग पुलिंग आर ऑल पार्ट ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. ये तो मैं कहता हूं ना, इलेक्शन इज द सेलिब्रेशन एंड फेस्टिवल ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. तो अब किसी ने कुछ बात, हाँ, बिलो स्टैंडर्ड कभी हमले नहीं होने चाहिए, लेकिन कभी कोई व्यंग करता है तो उस पर भी राहुल शिवशंकर को परेशानी है.
नहीं,
तो आगे से बोलना ही बंद करना पड़ेगा.
स्टैंडर्ड्स आप कह रहे हैं, जो बिलो स्टैंडर्ड्स आपकी पार्टी से लोग कुछ कहते हैं तो उन पे कोई कार्रवाई नहीं होती आपकी पार्टी की तरफ.
देखिए, अब ये आपका सोचना है. मैं जानता हूं हमारी पार्टी में सख्ती की जाती है, बातें बताई जाती हैं, लेकिन अब सारा आप सवाल हमसे पूछ रहे हैं. इतने कड़े 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 सवाल कभी कभी अपने नाम के राहुल गांधी से
वो
भी
तो आते ही नहीं है. We've been desperately requesting him, come to our platform, come
ना.
to times
एक
now.
मिनट, उन्होंने भारत के प्रधानमंत्री के बारे में क्या कहा? डंडे मारेंगे लोग, ये कौन सी भाषा है? तो कभी कांग्रेस के मित्रों से घेर कर पूछिए ना. आज तो देश के कानून मंत्री को आप खुलेआम ग्रिल कर रहे हैं, और मैं ग्रिल हो भी रहा हूं, थोड़ी ग्रिलिंग आपकी भी कर रहा हूं. लेकिन अच्छा होता कि ये सवाल आप उधर की पूछते, ये कौन सी भाषा है, तो अच्छा लगता.
इज संवाद इन डेंजर इन दिस कंट्री? वी हैव जस्ट हैड ए वेरी फ्री एंड फ्रैंक कॉन्वर्सेशन. दैट वॉज द टाइटल, इज डेमोक्रेसी अंडर थ्रेट? यू टेल मी, इज डेमोक्रेसी अंडर थ्रेट? Say it. No one is even going to go after you for saying no.
Ladies and gentlemen, be very honest. Did he ask me the toughest question or not? And did I evade any question? That's democracy.
The essence of samvad. Thank you, sir.
Thank
you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Raviji, and thank you, Rahul. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks very much for the first half of the day. I hope you've had a good time. We're having a quick